Hi everybody, it's November 14th. This is Brody from Brody's Garage, episode 15. 15 is going to be a bit of a, well, it's going to be an upper and a downer. I'll give you the good news first, and then we'll talk about some of the not so good news. The good news is, first of all, the weather has turned chilly here in Las Vegas, but I got this brand new space heater for the garage, and it's already doing a fabulous job of keeping the place nice and toasty, so that's good news. Some other good news is I just came back from the machine shop, and there it is, the LS3 aluminum block. We have cylinder heads, pistons down there. We have a flex plate. We have crankshaft. What do we got in here? Harmonic balancer, connecting rods, bearings, timing set. All the other goodies are in that box. And there's my subwoofer thing, which we've made some progress on. So that's all good stuff, right? All progress, all very good things. On to the not so good things. What's up, everybody? I am on the freeway. I'm not gonna take my eyes off the road, but I'm just about 15 minutes away from picking up my fenders here in Salt Lake City, Utah. It's about a 5-hour, 45-minute drive, I think, was the total time one way. And I'm going to turn right around and head back home to Vegas. My plan, if all goes well, is to maybe get home and pop the fenders on for a quick test fit and get them down, if all goes well and they look like they're in decent shape. I'm going to get them down to my buddy Chapo's shop to have them media blasted and get the bodywork process started on those. So let's see what they look like. Well, I just picked up my two fenders. They're in the back seat there. I didn't bother to get the camera out and film them while I was in there looking at them because of my utter disgust and disappointment. One of the fenders is a beat up piece of shit. The other one is far worse than that. I drove round trip yesterday up to Salt Lake City from Vegas, which round trip is about 875 miles total. I went up and back in one day with the expectation that I would pick up a set of used 67 Nova fenders. Now, I bought them off a guy on eBay. I won't give his name, but he lived in Western Montana, which was too far for me to go, and he didn't want to ship them. He goes, but you know what? There's a guy from Salt Lake that's coming up to get some other stuff, so why don't you get in touch with him? Here's his number. See if he'll pick up the fenders for you and bring them back to Salt Lake. Well, good news. He did. Brought them back to Salt Lake for me to his shop, and so I had to go up there and get them. And, of course, I'm going on a couple of not-so-good internet photos of the fenders and a description over the phone. And basically what I thought I was gonna get was, all right, they're definitely gonna be stripped down. You know, they'll need to be media blasted down to bare metal. There'll probably be some little kinks in it, you know, but the photos he showed me, there was no surface rust. What he didn't tell me or show me in the photographs very elusively was that the passenger side fender had been completely creamed down the whole side of it. And on the back side, there are no less than, I don't know, 12 holes that somebody drilled in to pull out the metal, which they didn't even pull it out even close to all the way. So there's probably that much Bondo over there in that passenger side fender. I'll see if I can get over there for a closer look. I'll flip the camera around. Well, this here is the driver's side fender, which, I mean, just enjoy all those different shades of primer. You got 15 shades of primer from various people, I'm sure, which is all over what appears to be an original, I don't know if it's Aztec tan or bronze, but I actually had a 67 Nova that was that color before. Anyway, you can see the massive cracks and just waviness and stuff here. And I did some rough alignment on the thing, and that's about as close as I could get it in about an hour. That doesn't mean that I'm done, and that doesn't mean that I'm throwing these things away, but that's as far as I got today with them. As you can see, pretty good gap here at the top, and they're aligned pretty well with the rockers, but in the middle, they're bowed out considerably. Now, It could be some problems with the door, but I think the door is actually fitting pretty well. The door's pretty flush with the rocker panel all the way. It lines up with the quarter panel, comes over. It's got a bit of a gap here, but I was already planning on welding this up and bringing the gap in closer, which I'm still probably going to do. Now on this driver's side fender, which by the way is the better of the two fenders, we'll get to the passenger in a minute, but maybe what I can do here, and if somebody has a suggestion, first of all, I don't know if you can see it, but when you get further down the road here on this fender, you can see there's a pretty massive dent right there. If you can see that line just goes, it's straight, and then it, you know, just dips right in there. So we got a massive dent to pull out there. And I don't know, but maybe on the back side of this fender, there's a metal brace that is spot welded all the way down this side here to stiffen that profile. What I may end up doing is cutting out that brace on the back side, or at least V-notching it, and giving some more flexibility to the outer skin so that I can move the outer skin, push it in where I need to, and then re-weld that support brace back in to hold it in tighter so that we don't have this big bowing out here. That's my thought for right now. Obviously the fender can come up a little bit here, but once again, if somebody sat on this thing and just kind of bowed the whole thing down and out in the middle, that's kind of what I'm thinking happened, is that somebody sat their fat ass right on there and just pushed the whole fender down and out. And so this needs to go in and up. That's my thoughts about this fender. Let's go take a look at the passenger side now, where things get really ugly. Now, honestly, that driver's side doesn't scare me all that much. I think we can work with it. Sorry about the lighting over here. I worked quite a bit on this side today, and we'll start with the good things. Ended up being a pretty decent gap up here. I mean, it's not perfect. As a matter of fact, I'm still actually a tad high here. I could actually pull this shim out and get this thing to sit down a little bit more flush with the cowl. So I'm not terribly frightened by this gap here. And overall, the contour is not so bad here. We've got a pretty major dent right down here. This is pushed in almost an inch, I would say, or 3/4 of an inch. It's so hard to tell because this thing is so spotted and dirty and caked on with grime and primer, and just everything has been laid on this thing. But where things get really bad is in here, and I can't show you right now because I didn't show you the back sides of the fender, but behind this entire length of panel here is Bondo. You can see that it's cracking out up here, cracking out there. Also up here, it's dented in, buckled in quite a bit. I mean, this thing is about -2, and I was expecting, maybe a 5 on a scale of 1 to 10. It's pretty bad. I don't know that I can salvage it. First thing first, I'm going to get this thing down to bare metal and see what we're dealing with and just see how much Bondo's in it and how bad the dents are. But if it's salvageable at all, it's going to have to be completely taken off and probably hammered from the backside out using a dolly or a block on this side, or maybe even a 2x4, and just maybe rubber hammering it out to get the whole thing to pop out a bit. And then we can work on shaping it. Maybe I'll get a heat shrinking disc and go over the surface it and get it, you know, until I can get the thing leveled out. But it is pretty bad. But having said all of that, you know, I learned my lesson. I was a little too trusting on this, and the guy took advantage of me. I'm in this pair of fenders for $450 for the pair. Plus, I spent close to $200 in gas round trip, and I threw the guy from Salt Lake $100 for his time for grabbing the fenders from Montana for me. So I'm in it for what? $450, $200, $300. That's $650. $750 for the pair of fenders. Now, to be fair, there were a lot of guys that wanted a lot more than that for a pair of fenders, but they were in better shape than these. So, you know, what are you going to do? live and learn. I'm going to give it a shot. I'm going to break them down to bare metal. I'll see what we've got to work with. And then, you know, if at that point I decide that I need to bail on them and find something else, then I will. Also got to fill in the antenna hole here, which is no big deal. Oh, by the way, these are my Ring Brothers hood hinges. They're very beautiful, aren't they? They're probably the nicest thing on the car right now. They're just waiting in place. Back here, I did get the 2-inch cowl induction hood, which I ordered from Real Deal Steel. Now, I got to say, I haven't tried to fit this thing on the car yet, but the quality of the finish and the construction of the underside of the hood is really, really nice. I mean, it's very, very impressive. Better than I expected. I can't show it all right now, but trust me when I say, if this thing fits as good as it looks, I'm going to be just amazed, okay? So I got that. I got the front and rear bumpers for the car, which I haven't even peeled off the wrapping to look at them. I've got the bumper filler panel up there, that black thing. I already had the grill from before. So, oh, and I've got a pair of headlight bezels, which I got from Classic Industries, which I think I talked about in an earlier episode, that they are not in perfect shape. For reprops, they are pretty scratched up. And I already contacted them, and I may end up sending those back. On the subject of headlight bezels, I was actually thinking, you know what? Maybe if there's a good set of NOS GM bezels out there, I'll buy them. I'll spend the extra money. Found a pair. Guy was selling a bunch of used ones and a pair of NOS ones. Well, he was a scammer. He had taken a picture off of another guy's profile from one of the Facebook groups that I belong to and just was trying to scam people out of money. But I don't know, the last couple days between that guy and the Fender guy, just a little disheartened, a little feeling a little dejected about humanity and my trust in people. Having said that, I'm going to suck it up and I'm going to do the very best I can with the Fenders. I've got the engine here to work on, so, you know, between the two things, I'll bounce back and forth. I started on my trunk project. I crawled underneath the deck lid and lined up my hinges in there, and I can see that they need to be welded about a half inch over from where they were originally welded. So anyway, that's the update for right now. You know, some setbacks as usual since the very beginning of this thing. There have been, you know, a step forward and a step sideways and a step backwards. It's like a little two-step dance. But I'm still optimistic. I'm still moving forward with the car. It actually, for the first time, looks like a 67 Nova sitting in the garage. So even though it's all beat up and mangled on the front end, it's starting to take shape as a car. And hopefully I'll get the engine together soon. I'll get these fenders at least diagnosed and find out what their prognosis is. Interior is on its way. I just found out that my seats from TMI and my door panels and headliner are completed, and they will be shipped out probably by this next week. I'll get them. So that's exciting. One thing I must say is that my biggest challenge, I guess, with this project is working in the garage. If you can see here, there's not a lot of room, and especially as you start accumulating parts and boxes and things, and there's just, I've crammed things into almost every nook and cranny of this garage. And I'm also sharing space with my significant other, Nina, who is a performer, and she runs a thing called Bella Electric Strings, which is a group of girls who play electric violin and cello, and they do everything from weddings and solo gigs to large corporate events, and they have a touring show called The Femmes of Rock, and it's pretty kick-ass, but, you know, she's got her entire wardrobe rack back there, so I have to be careful in here. I don't think I'll be painting any cars in here, or maybe I will, I just won't tell her. But, yeah, there's just limited real estate in here, and I think I probably spend at least a third of my time just moving something from this location over to there so that I have room to work over here. I wish I had a big shop. Maybe after this car is done, I'll get serious and do this for real, and I'll get a shop and a lift and all the big bad tools that I can afford and do it for real. But for now, the 67 Nova is going to be built here at home. And you know what? In spite of the setbacks, I'm happy with how it's coming along. So I will see you all in the next episode. Wish me luck and subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see how things keep going. It really helps me and I appreciate it. And I look forward to seeing you all in the next one. Take care.